So we all know dirt bikes and dual sports can be quite the adventure. It is true, the greater the risk, the better the reward. And with that risk, uncertainty comes. Things can go downhill very quickly. Let me tell you guys a little story that happened not too long ago, and why these fours are a must-have when out exploring or challenging yourself with two wheels. We ended up in a single track near Cristo Wilderness of Colorado, which by there is a famous single track called Sargent's. As we all know, single track can be a bit daunting at times. Now, to add on to the mix, we decided to do an old single track south of Hayden, the one that was labeled impassable.
Look at this view, man. This view is just awesome.
Now let me explain to you why we were allowed to do this trail. First of all, being three men seeing an impassable sign, yeah, let's prove who is wrong. On our way down from Hayden Creek to Big Cottonwood, we noticed a sign that said impassable. I know, we were digging our own graves, but it was also a lesson learned onto what could have happened if there was no signs or you stumbled into something like this out of the blue. Because it does happen all the time.
Came across this route over here. We ended up, so before you guys give me crap, because you might be like, oh, you're going off trail, it's closed. We actually called the ranger's office. And the reason they closed it is because they say it's not safe, it's dangerous. They said it's a washout, and they said you guys are more welcome to do it, but it's not enforced. Wow, this thing is really loose and a bunch of...
The reason we proceeded forward is because we got permission from the forest rangers. They did mention the trail is not closed, and there is no active closure. But the sign was more of a warning to dirt bike riders, and was there to act as a deterrent.
You can kind of see why they say it's not safe. Wow. To the left is definitely a sheer drop, man. It is a little nerve-wracking, especially with these burned trees sticking out. Trees are super sharp, man. They could really impale you.
Now here's when things get really funny. The ranger sent us a photo of a washout, so we only thought maybe it was two or three of these obstacles. And of course, it turned out every 10 minutes, there was some kind of obstacle, whether it was a washout, a landslide, logs, or just a steep creek crossing. Now let me tell you, the camera really flattened things out, and by far, in person, it's 30 times worse. Why we didn't turn around? Well, same reason why people get into this same ordeal. We go over one obstacle, then two, then three. Then you start thinking, do you really want to turn around and go through that again? Of course, you say no, so you keep on pushing. Three obstacles turn into six, then 10. Then before you know it, you are way over your head. You assume maybe there was two or three obstacles and that's it, everything else is smooth sailing. You just keep pushing forward, only matters just gets worse. This is when you start realizing the equipment you should have brought, and this trip taught me what are the true necessities. Because sign or no sign, it could happen to anyone. Even Everride released a video of a similar situation he was in with his KLR 650, I believe, and he is much of an experienced rider than all of us. The very first thing I wish I would have brought was an inline water filter to remove bacteria and drink water safely. Our journey was a total of a 14-hour ordeal, trying to get out actually. We all went through our entire water system and tried our best not to drink from the river. But as the day kept pushing forward, so did our limits on how dehydrated we were. We all eventually broke down and decided either organ failure, heat stroke, or drink from the stream and risk it. Without a doubt, fresh water would be the most important thing in this list, and that is why it is my first pick. My choice is the Sawyer filter just because it comes with a small container. You can use it as an inline filter for your Camelback, or use it as a straw to drink from the stream. Three different sources in case one of them fails.
So there's many different kind of water filters. For me, this one seemed the most practical, and especially for my kind of use, especially when I'm out dirt biking, it's actually the Sawyer water filter. So this right here is what sold me. It's super simple, super convenient. You have a little thing that says flow right over here to your little Camelback tube right over here. Now this tube, I actually got it from another Camelback. I just cut it right in half, put it in, and it connects just like that. So I just make sure the flow is facing, you know, in the correct direction. This part right over here, you just put it in the Camelback and you're ready to start drinking.
Now the second thing should be carried by all dirt bikers. I believe our ordeal could have been cut in half with a proper trail saw. There were just many obstacles that we had to push through, carry our bikes over, and get down on our knees to drag our bikes underneath these tree stumps. And most of these could have been avoided if we just had a trail saw. This possibly could have conserved a lot of energy and possibly a lot less pain. Now, this is something not to cheap out on. My choice is the Silky Professional Big Boy 2000 folding saw. It's a whopping 14 inches, and it's meant to cut through big logs, and believe me, this thing definitely works. If two or three dirt bikers carry this in your group, it can really make a huge difference in getting across the trail.
This is the Silky Big Boy 2000 360 6.5. It's made in Japan, so it's not some cheap made in China crap. I really trust Japan's engineering and craftsmanship. This thing is extremely, extremely sharp. Like, I'm surprised how sharp these blades are. And they're curved in a particular way. So they really, it's not like your average trail saw. This is curved very different. It's a huge blade, as you can see. It's a very big blade. And the handle is made out of rubber, so it's super easy to hold, very comfortable.
Now the most important thing, which is third on my list. Now this was a bit of an interesting story. Halfway into our ordeal, I started losing it, not making sense, not able to talk. There was a point in time I couldn't even ride my bike anymore because I was not coordinated enough. So this mountain life and Tommy had to ride the bike for me on most tough obstacles. Lucky for me though, this mountain life gave me something that really changed how it felt. And without this, I don't think I would have been able to have the strength to continue on and get out. I really don't think so. They are pricey, but can really be the difference between getting out or not due to your energy levels. And as silly as it sounds, it is the Honey Stringer Energy Chews. After feeling the effects of this, the price is definitely worth it. Believe me guys, I will never go to a trip without these anymore. Due to their price though, I will only use these as emergency, only like this scenario. I started to feel the effects within 30 minutes, and I started feeling like myself again, and able to get over most obstacles, and of course help my friends get over obstacles. By the end of the day, I still had plenty of energy to stand up riding my bike, which was pretty crazy. I went from almost being crippled, super nauseous, not making sense, to a normal person with energy. Don't get me wrong, I was still tired, but I had the energy to keep pushing forward, which is what really counts. Now the fourth thing is kind of a no-brainer, but we all agreed on something at the end. A 2-liter bladder is really worthless when you think about it, especially with a Camelback with minimal pockets. This little simple thing can have a huge impact. That extra 3 liters can be a huge deal if, say, one of your water filters goes bad, cracks, or perhaps gets lost. But it's just not the 3-liter bladder. Pockets are important too on your Camelback. It can keep your prized equipment along. And with these pockets, I can fit extra food, my water filter, and of course, an emergency tent that retains heat.
Now, I went with this Camelback for one reason. Well, actually, multiple reasons. It's a 3-liter bladder. Pockets are perfect. This is more than enough space. So all this water supply, all these filters, fit right in the tip right over here. It's a pretty durable material.
filter. And of course, the Camelback tube right over here. This one, again, is from another Camelback that I got. There's still a bunch of room in there. You got your other pocket over here. That can hold a lot of stuff, I'm telling you right now. That holds a bunch of stuff. And then my favorite part is you can put like these little mole patches right over here. This thing fits great as well. Surprisingly, it's super comfortable. And here's my favorite part. It has a little whistle. It has a little adjuster right over here. It has a double, so it has an on and off switch right over here. And then you can just drink from here. And then your waist, so this is one of my favorite features, is it holds onto your waist right over here. So I don't know if you guys see that.
During our ordeal, we just kept running into bad scenarios over and over again. It was just one after the other. We weren't sure if we were going to make it out in time, yet alone even have the energy. So we all started to think about finding an area to sleep and continue pushing on the next day. Lucky though, with the honey stringers, I was able to get myself that huge boost that I needed and continue pushing on. But everything was still the unknown from there on, which something as small as pockets to fit some extra supplies that are lightweight can have a huge impact. So after this ordeal, these four items is what really opened my eyes. It's like, I really should carry these with me. As far as the Camelback goes, this is fairly inexpensive, but the material is straight up solid. And you can also add additional moles on the back as well. My choice is the G4 Free Military Tactical Hydration Pack. There is definitely enough pockets to keep a lot of things in there, especially the water filters, your keys, your phone, and even extra food and supplies. And with an extra mole pack, you can actually double your capacity. Anyhow guys, if you guys like my content, go ahead and subscribe, but hit that bell button, and I'll catch you guys on my next video.